welcome over here to the first of the inspirational speakers events given by TREWO, or the Ripple Effect Wellness Center. I am only concerned with numbers and fundraising. Sudhi does the rest. So please visit our website, www.trewo.org. Make a donation if you want to. Become a member. It's very cheap. And like us on Facebooks and Twitters and all that, because when I go to sponsors, they want to see who, how many people I have supporting our organization. And we're getting there. So without wasting too much more time, thanks again. And now I'll get my co-founder in crime, or somebody calls him a rascal or whatever. We call him Santa Claus as well at Christmas parties. Dr. Sudhi Devanesen, thanks.
If I'm Santa Claus, then Ravi's an elf. But welcome, everybody, and thank you so much for taking time out from your busy day to be with us this evening. It's been quite an amazing adventure putting this evening together. We're going to start with the national anthem. And we have a very talented young man who's going to sing it for us. His name is Jules Coutinho. We now have a very wonderful contribution from Lata Pada's group, Sampradaya. And this is called Swagatam. It is a dance of welcome. And Lata has been a friend of the Ripple Effect. She has supported us at all our events since we began. Ladies and gentlemen, Swagatam from the Sampradaya Dance Creations. ladies and gentlemen, today we launched a book, a handbook, which all of you got a copy of. It's our first attempt to create something, and all the authors are members of the Ripple Effect Wellness Organization. They are here, Smita. I'm not sure whether Anjali is here and Sohini is here. The people who sweated over it, Rajiv Prasad and Ravi Juneja, they're also here. And we are very happy that one of our members of our board, Dr. Manish Mangi, managed to make it out tonight. So it's a book that we're very proud of. It's the first iteration. There'll be many more. And I hope you'll find it very useful. And I do thank these people for putting in hours and hours of work to get it together for today. I also want to invite you all to attend our Christmas party, dinner and dance, on December the 6th, and the information is in your hands. The Ripple Effect is working on many fronts in many different ways, but this is a new venture of ours, having an inspirational speaker, and something that we feel is important for all of us. We live in difficult and troubled times. And over the centuries, voices have been raised in trying to defend those who are defenseless, in trying to improve the quality of lives, to try and bring hope and joy and happiness of some kind to people. And when we look around, war and pestilence and anger and stress and trouble and loss, we want to hear voices of hope. We want to hear voices that renew that spirit and spark within us. One such voice is Pavithra Mehta. And we are absolutely delighted that she accepted our invitation. There are two people I want to thank in connection with this. One is Mr. Bana Mistry, who is a Gandhian and a follower of Gandhi, who has a huge Gandhi library. He is the first one who brought that to my attention and sent me the link for Pavi's TED talk. And I was totally blown away by it. I was determined to bring her here. I told Ravi, "Ravi, we have to get her here." He said, "Okay, Sudhi, you do it." Okay. So I said, "Now, where do we begin?" Fortunately, Mr. Panchapakesan, who has known Pavi's family for many years, got me her details and I was able to connect with her. And this, ladies and gentlemen, was in February of this year. And this is the date we got now to get Pavi over. And we're so, so delighted that she can be here and she can address us. She's an outstanding personality. She has done what she speaks of, she does. Seva is the thing that motivates her. She speaks with passion. She speaks with a lot of wisdom. And we had dinner with her last night, our committee, and we were just taken up by her graciousness, her humility, and her generosity of spirit. So we hope to have this as an annual event. And ladies and gentlemen, I'm so delighted that I can call to the podium Pavi Mehta.
Dr. Devanesen's invitation was hard to refuse. And I've just been so touched by the spirit and the warmth of welcome from the Ripple Effect family. It really does feel like a family. I wish I could sing or dance to entertain you, but I'm going to have to rely on PowerPoint instead. And I just want to say that one of the things I often confess to my audiences in the beginning is that I come from a family of 25 eye surgeons who all work in the same organization. And I'm a storyteller in a family of surgeons. So it's been an interesting journey. And one of the things I feel that I've learned is that there are stories in our world that help us see each other, ourselves, and our place here a little bit better. Stories, in a way, can be like eye surgery. And I hope to be able to share some of those sight-restoring stories with you today. I'd like to begin by bringing a very beautiful person into the room. Mahatma Gandhi once said, "Earth provides enough to satisfy every man's need, but not every man's greed." We live in a time of unprecedented disparity. Oxfam published a report earlier this year that revealed the shocking information that the 85 richest people in the world are worth more than the poorest 3.5 billion people combined. The richest 1% accounts for nearly half the world's wealth. As this rich-poor divide increases, so do our levels of isolation. It's the paradox of our era. We live in a time where Facebook has created over 150 billion online connections. Collectively, we shell out 4.5 billion likes on status updates every single day. And yet a growing body of science is showing us what we already know in our gut. People are lonelier than ever. And what is the danger of that loneliness? The increased mortality risk, studies have shown, the increased mortality risk of loneliness is comparable to that of smoking. It's twice as dangerous as obesity in terms of the threat it poses to our well-being. So we live in a time where people are more isolated, lonely, unwell, and unhappy than before. It's not a rosy picture. But thankfully, there are people all over the world and in every walk of life who are doing something to change that. A friend of ours was in the subway station recently. She was running to catch a train and a homeless man approached her, asking for change. She shook her head no and brushed past him. She got to the ticket machine and she realized she was 10 cents short and her train was going to arrive any minute. So there she is, frantically looking through her purse, you know, looking for that spare bit. And suddenly she sees a hand extended, holding a dime. And she looks up, and it's the smiling face of the homeless man she'd just ignored. He was gifting her his spare change. And in that moment, she underwent this little transformation, and she realized that generosity has nothing to do with the size of our wallets, and everything to do with the size of our hearts. This is not an unusual story. There are tens of thousands of stories like this. I'm sure every single one of you sitting in this audience has experienced an unexpected act of kindness, generosity, compassion from a stranger that has lit up your life in that moment, perhaps changed your life in some way. We're gonna delve into the story of some of these giftivists, but first let's look at that phrase. Giftivism. It's a phrase we coined to refer to the practice of radically generous acts that transform our world. There have been giftivists in all corners, in all times, people who deeply believe that when you change yourself, you can fundamentally change the world. Mahatma Gandhi, the Dalai Lama, Nelson Mandela, Mother Teresa, all of these people. But giftivism isn't just the realm of these kinds of social change giants. The seeds of it lie in every single one of us. But to tap into that, we have to do something that these people did. We have to recognize the powerful truth that everybody, in every moment, has something of value to give the world. Service Space was founded on